Jeb Corliss could be the bravest man around, or the craziest. Defying death is his day job. Jeb is the Birdman. From mountains, helicopters, and the world's tallest buildings, he flies in a specially designed wingsuit at speeds of 200 kilometres an hour. It's breathtaking, and there's no margin for error. So when Jeb recently miscalculated by a fraction of a centimetre, well, let's just say, watch what happens next. Ross Coulthart reports.
I do believe that I am pushing the very boundaries of what's possible. And that's what my life is all about. My life is about taking things and seeing how far we can go. And when you do that, you know, you don't really know where that line is until you cross it. Life is just a bunch of experiences you have till you die, you know? And this was an absolutely spectacular experience.
Jeb came as close to dying as you possibly can.
We were born without time.
I was diagnosed with a condition when I was younger called counterphobia, an almost pathological desire to confront fear. When things have scared me, I have been compelled to do them.
Fearless and armed, quietly we'd fade into sleep.
I first met Jeb in 2009. We were in Malaysia. Jeb was base jumping from the KL Tower.
It's a bloody long way down.
He's part man, part bird. Part crazy. Wearing his wingsuit, Jeb Corliss risks his life for the ultimate thrill, to fly free as a bird, but at 200 kilometres an hour. It's an extreme pursuit that has killed many of Jeb's best friends.
Oh no!
Jeb, do you have a death wish?
If I had a death wish, I'd be dead. Think about it. If I wanted to die, do you think I would survive after doing all these incredibly dangerous things? No. If you want to die, guess what's going to happen? You're going to die.
Jeb's latest exploit is what he calls terrain flying. Flying so fast and so close to a mountain, he can almost touch it.
And I had been practicing it a lot in a place in Switzerland that we call the crack. And at that place, you know, I had a guy holding the balloons, 6-foot string, balloons on the end, and he's holding them, and he starts dragging them lower and lower because he starts getting scared that I'm gonna hit him. Where I jumped from was a mile away from where my balloons were. So from a mile away, I was able to then pinpoint and hit a spot that was 5 feet by 2 centimeters.
I came extremely close on that one.
Last year, Jeb took this accuracy to a whole new level. In China, he didn't just fly over a mountain or next to it, he flew through it.
And as I'm looking down, I'm just like, what are all these people doing down there? Like, there's so many people. And I just flew over all their heads, and it was one of the most spectacular jumps I've ever done in my life. It was really special. And it aired live to almost 500 million people. The press just kept saying, so when is enough enough? When are you gonna stop doing this? And I'm just looking at them, I'm like, would you ask a bird, you know, when are you gonna stop doing that silly flying thing? It's like, no, it's what birds do, they fly, right? If you had the ability to fly, would you ever give up? Never, no, flying is awesome. I will do flying until I die. I mean, there's nothing that's gonna stop me from flying.
Overlooking Cape Town in South Africa sits the majestic Table Mountain, a base jumper's dream.
Jeb just said, hey man, wouldn't it be cool if we went to South Africa and we jump off Table Mountain? And I was like, yeah, it would be great.
How are you doing back there, Joby?
Good, bro.
Joby Ogwin is Jeb's best mate. In January, they set out for 3 days of terrain flying.
The first jump, Jeb and I both went immediately down to the terrain and started taking a look at it. And, you know, at that point, I knew this is going to be an interesting trip.
Yes,
and they walked away.
Oh man!
Wow!
I'll tell you what, bro. Man, I haven't had the juice flowing like that in a while.
It's the most powerful feeling of flight, true human flight, that you can have. And the closer you are to this terrain and these mountains and these places like that, the more powerful the experience is. What do you think that you're made?
Yeah.
Over 2 days, Jeb and Joby made 4 successful jumps.
Yes! Good one, bro.
I suspect that Jeb and I were, you know, a foot or two off the cliff at most jumps, and we're going well over 120 miles an hour for most of what we were doing on table.
That was beautiful. Truly, truly beautiful.
Table Mountain had become my playground, and all of a sudden, I got very overconfident in my abilities, and I thought that I could just do whatever I wanted there.
On the third and final day, they set up for one more.
There's no question that I made a choice to do something a little more hardcore that day.
Okay, 10 seconds.
Normally, we have the balloon set about 6 feet, and I'm usually doing about 120 miles an hour as I'm coming through the balloons. I'm at the top and I see the two balloons before stepping off, and I can see that the black balloon's much lower, and I kind of am like, I'm gonna go for the lower one. I jump off and basically everything becomes very focused. It's like, it literally is, like you focus in on your target and it's like, I'm hitting that. And what happened was one of the balloons blew down and it actually hooked on rocks. So the string hooked on some rocks, holding the balloon down, basically on rock level. And then I start leaning over. And as I start leaning this wingsuit over, I start generating speed. You can just feel the speed. It's just like the power of the suit. And as I'm coming through, there's basically these boulders that I'm coming in between.
I heard this loud boom. It was so loud, and it echoed off of the rocks. The mountain is like an amphitheater, so you just hear this loud crash.
At that moment, as you hit, are you thinking, it's all over, I'm dead?
You're gonna die. There's no stopping death now. You're dead. So you've got two choices. You can either not pull, you know, and have a quick, painless death, or you can pull and basically suffer, because you're gonna die anyway.
And so immediately, I just radioed and said, I think he's dead. I'm pretty sure of it. But call the helicopter immediately. Maybe, maybe, maybe.
Into the cliff, hard impact. I can't see, I can't move. And really, all I fear is horrifying pain.
Jeb?
The thought of losing him that quick, I couldn't deal with that. I couldn't imagine it.
Jeb, stay awake, buddy. Talk to me.
Jesse,
you have to, but my friend, just let's keep still. Please keep still and just stay awake for me.
Because all of our friends are dead. From climbing or base jumping or wingsuit flying, they've all gotten wiped out. It's kind of just a few of us left.
There was a moment where finally I kind of got to this point where I could feel myself dying. There's actually a euphoric feeling as you start to die. It's a very powerful sensation. And as you start like letting go, I got really happy.
Jeb, you gonna move down a little bit?
I think I came as close as you can come to watching a friend die that day. To me, if, in my mind, for an hour, I thought that's what I'd seen. And, you know, it's a miracle.
I broke my right ankle. I broke my left ankle. I broke my left fibula. I tore my ACL out of my left knee. I degloved both thighs, so basically all of the flesh was ripped off the bone on both sides. I tore a huge monster chunk of flesh out of my shin, which needed skin grafting.
After 6 weeks in hospital, Jeb is back in California to begin his rehabilitation.
I'm basically learning how to walk again, and it's a difficult process, but you know, I'm glad that I have legs to do rehab on.
Better. Perfect steps right there.
So what's next?
My next project is I'm gonna do a touch and go on purpose. So instead of doing it accidentally, I'm gonna actually go and I'm gonna start touching things on purpose. That's when I get healthy, that's my next thing.
Yeah. What a beautiful, beautiful life.
Hats off to Jeb, but when I'm viewing life from up that high, I think I'd prefer a seatbelt and a safety demonstration. After the break, the unforgettable love story of the only Australian to survive the sinking of the Titanic.